this video will study about the R.H. Whitaker's five kingdom classification. In the previous video we have done the classification system of R.H. Whitaker, which includes five kingdom. Of those five kingdom, the first one is Monera, which includes all the prokaryotic one, and here the Monera includes all types of bacteria which are prokaryotic in nature. You know, prokaryotic means the cells having no true nucleus or other membranous cell organelles, and the nucleus is not there, although the genetic material is present in the region, and that region is known as nucleoid. Or chromosome number is also 1, and here other cell membranous cell organelles are totally absent. In spite of that, some other organ parts are there of the cell, inside the cell body. Now this is prokaryotic in nature, and all the bacteria include, the Monera kingdom includes two types of bacteria, that is Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. Archaebacteria, Eubacteria is known as true bacteria. Now the general features of bacteria, the general common characteristic features, first of all habitat, where does they found? All the bacteria are omnipresent, that means they are found in everywhere, that is soil, water, air, desert, then hot spring, then on the body of other organisms, on your hand. So it is present everywhere, that's why it is known as omnipresent. So first characteristic feature is habitat. The next one is nutrition. What is mode of nutrition? How bacteria take their food? First of all, they are categorized into two categories, that is autotrophs as well as heterotrophs. In autotrophs, some groups are there which can prepare their own food. That means they are photosynthetic in nature, having chlorophyll A, like blue green algae. And some are chemosynthetic, that means they are preparing their food, their autotrophs, but not from the light energy. They are taking their food from the chemicals. The inorganic chemicals are oxidized to make their food. They are utilizing that ATP for their day-to-day activity, and that's why nutrition includes phototrophs, then chemotrophs, as well as heterotrophs. Some are pathogenic in nature, some are decomposers, that means saprotrophs. So in this way, all types of nutrition mode is present in bacteria. Then types of bacteria, depending upon their shape, there are four types of bacteria. When they are circular in shape or spherical, then they are known as coccus, and plural is cocci. Then when they are rod shaped, then their name is bacillus, and if they are in plural more number, then bacilli. Then comma shape is known as, the example is viprium. Then spirillum is spring like structure, spiral. Now they may be either flagellate or non-flagellate. If flagella is present on the cell body, then it is known as flagellate, and if it is absent, then known as aflagellate. Now if flagella is present at one point, like suppose like this, then it will be known as monotrichus. If on the both the side, at two side, then it will be known as ditrichus, and if it is present all the sides on the surface of the cell, then it will be known as peritrichus. So depending upon the shape and presence of flagella, they are of different types. All the bacteria are categorized into two, that is Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. Eubacteria is also known as true bacteria. Now this Archaebacteria live in most of the harsh conditions, like very salty water, hot springs, then in marshy area. Depending upon the habitat, they are of different category, that is halophiles, which are present in the salty area. Then hot springs, they are known as thermoacidophiles. Marshy areas, they are known as methanogens. They are producing the gas methane. Some of the methanogens are also present in the gut of the ruminant animals, and that's why the dung has a characteristic odor. Now all these bacteria have different types of special type of cell wall, and that is necessary for their survival. Now, true bacteria is known as true bacteria, and it is having a big group of bacteria, big number of big category of bacteria, and some special features of this U bacteria are all these have rigid cell wall made up of three layers, and that is then having flagella if they are motile in nature, having some cilia for different purpose. Then depending upon the mode of nutrition, they are of different types like cyanobacteria, chemosynthetic bacteria, and heterotrophic bacteria. Now, cyanobacteria, because they have a specialized type of chlorophyll A, a special type of pigment, and that's why they are photosynthetic in nature. They are autotrophs, and they can fix the atmospheric nitrogen into the soil, and hence they are capable of increasing the fertility power of the soil. Now, they have different types of structure. Either they may be unicellular or multicellular. Multicellular, then some are living in colony groups, and then they are known as colonial, or they may be filamentous, having different filaments. They can live in fresh water, some are marine water also, having a special type of gelatinous sheath around the cell wall, and that gelatinous sheath is present around the cell, and this is known as gelatinous sheath. Now, nitrogen fixation can be done or done by this bacteria, cyanobacteria or blue green algae, for example Anabena, Nostoc, Oscillatoria, etc., and they fix the atmospheric nitrogen into the soil, and that make available for other plants. Now, they have a special type of cells in between, and that cells is known as heterocyst. This heterocyst helping them in the process of nitrogen fixation. Now, chemosynthetic bacteria, they are also autotrophs, but they have no special type of pigment. They are not photosynthetic, but they are chemosynthetic. That means they oxidize the inorganic substance and make the ATP. They and fix them in the nitrate, nitrite, ammonia, etc., and they help in the recycling of the minerals like iron, sulfur, phosphorus, nitrogen, etc. Now, very big number of bacteria are present in the category that is known as heterotrophic, and they may be either decomposers, pathogens, or symbiotic. Now, symbiotic association means the special type of relationship between two organisms in which both get benefited. For example, rhizobium. Rhizobium is living in the root nodules of the pulse plant, that is leguminosary plants, and they fix the atmospheric nitrogen, and in turn they are getting the food as well as shelter from the that plant, that is leguminosary plants. Now, pathogens, which are responsible, they are heterotrophic, and they are responsible for various types of disease, that means they are parasitic in nature, and like in plants, citrus canker, in animals, typhoid, jaundice, etc. So different types of disease occur through the bacteria. Then decomposers are also known as saprotrophs, because they depend upon the decaying parts of the plants as well as organism, and they break the complex material into the simpler one, and in this way they are also cleaning our atmosphere. In this way they are helping us in cleaning the atmosphere, and they are also helping in recycling of the minerals. In this way we can see there are different types of bacteria having different characteristic feature. Now, one of the very important feature of the bacteria is reproduction. How they reproduce? Generally, they reproduce asexually by the process of fission. Fission means the cell will grow in size, attain maturity, and then it will divide into two. It is known as the fission. First of all, their nuclear part will, and all the parts of the cell will be divided among the two cells, that is known as fission. During the unfavorable condition, they will undergo sporulation, that means they will produce the spores. So by the help of the spores, they will overcome that unfavorable condition, and when the favorable condition will come, then they will germinate to produce new bacteria. And in some cases we can see sexual reproduction also. Sexual reproduction is a special type, and that is known as conjugation, in which the DNA is transferred. One of the two bacteria will come closer. One bacteria will act as the donor and other as the recipient. And a special structure, that is pili, will help the bacteria in this process. And then the DNA will be donor. This is recipient. Some part of DNA is transferred here, and that is known as conjugation. That will also revise through this diagram. In this slide, we can see the kingdom Monera, how it is classified. It is mainly classified into two, that is Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. All of these are prokaryotic in nature. That means having primitive type of cellular structure, no nucleus is there, or membranous cell organelles are totally absent. Now, these Archaebacteria can live in all the various types of harsh conditions like salty area, marshy area, hot springs, cattle's gut, etc. Whereas Eubacteria are of various types depending upon their mode of nutrition. Some are autotrophs and some are heterotrophs. Autotrophs are again are of two types, that is photoautotrophs as well as chemoautotrophs. Photoautotrophs examples are cyanobacteria or blue green algae, which can perform the activity of photosynthesis, and hence they are known as photoautotrophs. And they are also capable of fixing the atmospheric nitrogen into the soil. Whereas proteobacteria or anaerobic bacteria live without oxygen, and some of the bacteria, heterotroph bacteria, are also pathogenic in nature and responsible for various types of diseases. The autotrophs are also of chemoautotrophs, which are capable of producing their food from the minerals or the chemicals. Now we can see here also the kingdom Protista, which showing the link with all the other higher organisms, group of organism like planty, that is plant like, which are photosynthetic protista. Now slime molds, which belong to this protista, are fungi like, so it is showing the connecting link between fungi and the protista. So in the same way here, protozoan protista show the connecting link between this protista and animalia, because they are like animal like. All of these protista are unicellular as well as eukaryotic, whereas in Monera they are prokaryotic, but in Protista all the members are eukaryotic in nature. This slide we have already discussed previously, and it is here Monera kingdom is divided into two, Eubacteria or true bacteria as well as Archaebacteria. You can see here Archaebacteria are named differently depending upon their habitat. Some are living in salty areas, which are known as halophiles, which are living in hot springs are known as thermoacidophiles, and which are living in marshy areas or the gut of the cattle is known as methanogens. They are capable of producing the gas methane. That's why the dung of the cattle is of characteristic odor. Now the eukaryotic bacteria or true bacteria having very wide range of bacteria, which are heterotrophic as well as autotrophic. Their mode of nutrition is like that. And the autotrophs are of two types, chemoautotroph and photoautotroph. Photoautotrophs are those which can prepare their food from the by using the sunlight, whereas chemoautotrophs, which are producing their food by using the chemicals or minerals in place of sunlight. That's why they are known as chemoautotrophs. Examples of chemoautotrophs are sulfur bacteria, and photoautotrophs are cyanobacteria or blue green algae. These are also capable of
fixing atmospheric nitrogen into the soil, and hence they are increasing the fertility power of the soil. They have a specialized type of structure in between the cell body, and that's why those are known as heterocysts, and which are making the blue-green algae for capable of the fixing of this nitrogen of atmosphere in the soil in nitrite nitrate form. Now, heterotrophic bacteria are of also various types. Some are saprotrophs, which are depending upon the decaying materials for their survival, and they act as a decomposer and cleaning our environment. Some are parasite, and they are responsible for various types of disease for human as well as animal. In this way, we can see kingdom Monera includes all the organisms which are prokaryote in nature and which can live everywhere. That's why Monera kingdom or the bacteria are known as omnipresent. They are cosmopolitan, living in various areas, all parts of the world: air, water, land, all the places, hot condition or cold condition. So everywhere they are present, and they are their habitat is everywhere, as well as their mode of nutrition is of various types. You can see in this slide different types of organisms or bacteria. See, Monera shows having thermoacidophile, living in hot spring, halophiles, living in salty area, methanogens in marshy areas, then cyanobacteria, which are photosynthetic in nature, gram positive bacteria having a special type of structure in their body, that's why they are staining, taking some stain, that's why known as gram positive bacteria. Some are proteolytic, some are spirochete. So these are different classes of bacteria. In this slide, we can see the structure of Monera members. That is the bacteria having very simple type of structure. This is the cellular structure of bacteria. You can see here this is the outer layer or the cell envelope, which is consisting of three layers: plasma membrane, cell wall, and outermost capsule, and that is known as capsule. Now, a long thread-like structure, flagellum, is there, which help in the process of movement. This small thread-like structure is known as pilus, having various functions, as well as they are helping in the conjugation process or sexual reproduction. Now, internal part of the cell consists of this cytoplasm. This cytoplasm includes ribosome, which are 70S type and helping in the process of protein synthesis. DNA is present in the locality known as nucleoid, and no true nucleus is there. Here you can see pili helps in movement. Cell wall provides the special structure, support and protection to the bacteria, and cytoplasm is the fluid part having organelles. Now, ribosomes making different types of proteins, and flagella helps in the movement process. Chromosomes are circular DNA, which is transmitting the characters from one generation to other. Other than this circular DNA genetic material, one DNA, extra chromosomal DNA, is also there, known as plasmids.
Bacteria are classified on the basis of their shape and structure. Here we can see different types of shape. If it is spherical, then it is known as coccus, and plural, that is cocci. If it is rod shaped, known as bacillus or bacilli, and if it is spiral like or spring like, known as spirillum, and if it is comma shaped, then known as vibrio. This diagram is this slide is also showing the shape of the bacteria, different types of bacteria depending upon their shape. Different names are there. If it is singular, then cocci, coccus, and if more than one, plural term is cocci. Here two cells are together, that's why known as diplococci. Some of the example of this coccus is that is Streptococcus pneumoniae, which is responsible for the pneumonia disease. Now, these are also some examples: Neisseriae, then as candidae have different types of disease they are producing. Now here bacillus, rod shaped bacteria is known as bacillus, and plural term is bacilli. Some of the examples are mycobacteria or corynebacteria. Then when it is comma shaped or curved rod like, then known as vibrio, and if it is spirillum, that is spring like, known as spirilla. Beside that, bacteria having flagella or not, flagella may be present or not. If it is present, known as flagellate, and if it is not present, aflagellate. Flagella may be at one end or both the end, so depending upon that different names are there, like mono, if single flagella is there, monotrichus, two flagella known as ditrichus. If flagella present on a whole around the surface, body surface, then known as peritrichus. In this way, various names are there, types of bacteria, depending upon the shape as well as the presence or absence of flagellum. Bacteria show different types of reproduction. Out of that, the most common is the phygen. In phygen, the parental bacterial cell grow in size, and then it will undergo phygen to form, divide to form two daughter bacterial cell. You can see here, this is the bacterial cell, parental cell, and the bacterial chromosome is there in the nucleoid region, and this is the cell wall. Now the chromosome will undergo replication, that means formation of one chromosome, will DNA will replicate, doubled in the number, and then it will undergo growth. Cell will also undergo the process of growth. Then the nucleus, that karyogamy will take place, nucleus will divide into two, that nucleoid part, that is chromatin material, will divide into two, and then finally the cell will also divide into two. In this way, from one parental cell, two daughter cells are formed with the chromatin material, and this phenomena is known as phygen. This figure is showing about the conjugation process in bacteria. Actually, bacteria show a special type of sexual reproduction, which is known as conjugation. In conjugation, two bacteria, one as a donor and one as a recipient bacteria, will come closer. This is the pili. That pili will attach here, and the wall between these two adjacent wall will dissolve. In this way, it will make a passage in between them. Now, this bacterial chromosome, from bacteria A, you can see here, will be some part of this chromosome will be transferred in bacteria B, and this phenomena is known as transfer of genetic material, and this is also known as conjugation. So this is special type of sexual reproduction. This slide is showing the phenomena of bacterial conjugation and recombination. We can see here, these are two cells, one as a donor and one as a recipient. From here, the conjugation, this is the conjugation tube. Through this conjugation tube, some part of this chromosome is transferred here, and this transferred chromosome will attach with this chromosome, and in this way this bacteria have some will undergo recombination, its own DNA as chromosomal part as well as from the donor side. So here the genetic makeup will be different from these bacteria, and having some special characters because these chromosomes are also inserted here, and this is known as bacterial conjugation, which is a special type of sexual reproduction. And due to the recombination, there may be some superior characters or inferior character, that means change of the genetic makeup, and that is known as recombination.